here we go then. What we got here in this vid is that single pole fuse, and we're going to give it a little clean up and a restore in this vid. Yeah, let's get on with it. That is a single pole, single phase fuse. Okay, live conductor goes in there and comes out the top there. Okay, you have two live conductors coming out the top of that and two going in the bottom, or one coming in, going through and then coming back out onto another fuse maybe. Okay, 100 amp max, I don't think it says on there, nope. It just says Mark II made in England, if I can get on that. Made by BICC. But I've got a feeling the maximum fuse you can put in that anyway is 100 amp fuse. It's quite firmly gripped in there, if you just bear with me. Right, there's the where it goes in, terminal screws in there, and there's your fuse. Okay, now I want to give this a clean up and a restore, because if you look on that, it's all a bit dirty and mucky on there. It's all a bit gunked up. And I've got a feeling what basically happened with this is with the wiring in there, that terminal screw came loose, it got a bit hot in there, all the insulation's melted, it's gone in there and gunked it all up. Okay, you can see all the gunk and rubbish on there, and then it obviously goes a bit runaway with itself, because the more dirt and gunk and rubbish you get in there, the higher resistance, the more heat it makes. And the same with the one down the bottom there. Screwdriver. Let's get that in there then. It comes out. And there's our terminal there. Yeah, it's all on the end of the screwdriver now. So I can just scrape it off. It looks like as if it's grease. And look, it's all on the end of the screwdriver. So there we go. Probably not melted insulation then. But we're going to take the terminal screws out anyway and chuck it in the parts washer. That's what we're going to do. And we're also going to take this apart as well and clean that up. And then we're going to put a nice little shine on it. Other brands of polishes are available, of course. And then we'll put it back together. Let's get them terminal screws out then. If a epoxy screwdriver stop hitting the other terminal screw, maybe I should take the terminal screws out first before removing the block from the holder. That'd be another option, wouldn't it? There we go, it's two terminal screws out. Is that camera doing that clickety click thing again? I can hear it doing something. If that's going in and out and all over the place, do excuse that. There's not much I can do when it starts going in and out and clickety clicking all over the place like that. Right, there's all the terminal screws out of that one then. I don't know what material that is, metal, but one thing I do know is that has to have compatibility with aluminium conductors. because if that was made out of copper or brass and you stuffed an aluminium conductor in and tightened it up, you would get some kind of electrolytic effect happen and it would all sort of corrode up in there. Okay, so I don't know what material that is, but I don't think it's brass or copper. So there we are. Let's pull that to one side. None of that gunk is on the terminal screws. So maybe we'll wash that gunk off in the parts washer. I'm going to get the terminal screws out of that block while it's still inside the holder. That's one. Two. Three. Four. All the terminal screws are out of there then. Now what we do is we release the terminal block from the holder. Oh, pardon me. Right, there's the other one. Get a bit gunky on there. Again, we'll clean it up in the parts washer. So that's hose over there with that. And there's the two little screws which hold those into that. Next up then, we're going to take this apart. One, two, and fuse drops out. I've already done a video on this. Can you remember what size fuse was in this? Amp, Dorman Smith, and that is British Standard 1361 1971. What I plan to do with this then is actually get those copper pins out. That's just a case of loosening that. There, that comes out. Okay, and that screw, and then that, if I just pinch it together, there you go, it comes straight out. After I clean that up, what I'm going to do is I'm going to polish these surfaces there and there, and inside around there, okay, the contact surfaces, okay, all that on the top there. Won't need to do that because that's not a contact surface. Okay, so we'll clean that up. That can go in the parts washer. We'll loosen the other one off as well. Another one of those. There's that in there. Just squeeze it together and it comes out. And there's an empty. There you go. There. Okay. No electrical bits left in that now. Right, what I'm going to do then is I'm going to prepare the parts washer. There it is. Let's open up the top. There's our little parts basket. Put the handle on. Like so, one handle attached, and all the bits can go in. There we are then. We're all in there. That fits in there superbly. Okay, let's see if I can lie that down. There we are. And that. I want it to be fully immersed in there. For the optimum fizz when we put it in. Okay then. In they go down. Have a nice little soak in there. Do you like your surface views? Right, what are the little soak in there? There we go, lift it out. Let's start cleaning. Other brands are available, of course, don't forget. Is that camera doing that clickety-click thing again? It's doing something, isn't it? Stop it. I don't know what that gunk is on there. I think I'm getting it off. If not, I'll have to get the metal polish out and never go at that. I think it's coming off. We'll soon find out when I rinse it off. Do the other one. Right, let's have a look at that before I clean it all off, clean all the rubbish off. Okay. I think it's the movement of hands triggering that off. I've had some better lighting. I've turned all the lights on now in the kitchen, already done that one. It's still doing it. If that's going in and out like that, do excuse that, but there's not much I can do about it. I tried turning the lights or extra lights on in the kitchen, but it's still doing that clicky click thing. Right, I think I've got all that dirt and gunk off. Let's try them copper pieces. It was all in there. Well, them internal sections are removable, I think. Yeah, look, that internal copper section is removable. To be able to polish that up and put that back in there, that's epic, I like that. It's a nice bit of satisfaction right there. Right, it's definitely getting there. Make sure that little insert is cleaned up as well, because that's got a bit of gunk and rubbish on it. I can hear that camera really doing something. It is, isn't it? This other one. Let's see if I can get that copper section removed out of there. That's how it comes out. You just, when that's in there, you just push backwards on it and then it releases out of them latches. Now that's a proper dirty, gunky one that is. I might need to wipe that off with a bit of kitchen towel first. There you go, it's just come straight off of there. So maybe that hot water loosened it off. Those edges are a bit sharp. You've got to be careful with these things, not slip and cut yourself on it. Maybe I've got the camera too close or something. It's still going, isn't it? I thought that one looked a bit too clean. I was cleaning up the wrong one. Look at that. Rightio then, most of that discoloration on there, I will get that off with a bit of polish. But generally speaking, I've cleaned it up reasonably well. Shove that up one end, so I'm just going to re-dunk that. Parts like this, you don't want to use any of that abrasive cleaner because it will scratch all the surfaces up. Okay, just a wet toothbrush and away you go. Oh, definitely getting bouquet phenolic resin off of this. Oof. The smell of this stuff when you warm it up. Oof. The smell that comes off it. Right, let's get it towards the kitchen worktop and you can have a look at the completed job in there. There it all is then. Yeah, they're looking relatively cleaned up now, aren't they? And that's... Yep, that's looking good to me. And a couple pieces. And that's before I've put the shine on them. And another one. That's shining already. One light. I'm going to put that back in soak. Thank you. there we are then. What we've got up in front of the camera is one fully cleaned up and restored, ready to go. BIC 100 amp service fuse. Okay, single phase, single pole. Okay, now when I say BIC, that is BICC. Okay, yeah, let's zoom in on it. There it is then. There's the fuse holder section. When I cleaned it up and dried it, I did actually decide that it doesn't need to be polished up, those copper sections, because they're quite nice and shiny enough as it is. Okay. You can feel the shine on those straight away. Okay. And on the other side. There. And there's the fuse inside there. There we are. The actual terminal block itself. There we go. All nice and clean in there once again. It's a bit of a shame that that thing's broke in the middle there, but you can still get a screw in there out the back and secure it to a wall anyway, so I'm not terribly bothered by that. It could be worse. Like I say, it was a salvage bit of electrical kit, so there you go. There's the where the power comes out, okay, because it'll go in the bottom up there through the fuse and then out into that one and out in the top there. I've got a feeling that probably the maximum conductor size you can get into that is 25mm. Okay, so there it is. Let's put it back together then. There we are. Hope you enjoyed watching that one. I've got to put away the parts washer because it's still got all the water in it by the kitchen sink and have a nice little tidy up. Okay, a little bit later on we'll be doing more vids, taking things apart and cleaning them up and restoring them like that up in front of the camera there. And yeah, stay tuned for that. Okay, so thanks for watching this one, people.